Hi everyone, it's Leonor with LDM Creations. Today I'm making a non-claustrophobic face mask. I'm sure that many of us or many people have that same issue. I feel like that I'm being contained when I have a big face mask on. So I found this pattern online. I'll post the link on the description where I got a pattern from. And I found that it felt really well and it didn't feel claustrophobic. So let's go ahead and get started. This one is basically two layers of fabric, and I'll post a link to the pattern where I got it from. And I just pinned the two layers with my pin, and then I began to cut the fabric. The holes that you see in the pattern, you don't need to cut those, okay? You basically, that's just a reference for you to know where the elastic is going to be placed at. So I'm going to go ahead and finish cutting all the stuff. The notches on the side that you see are basically to be sewn in together to make the face mask fit better under your chin. Those are the only two notches that you actually have to cut out and then sew. And then I cut two pieces of 8-inch elastic to go around my ears. So in here, basically, I'm putting the fabric face, I guess the pretty side face inside. And then I put the elastic and pin it where I marked it with my pen. So I could then later on sew it together. So the first step is to sew the little slits, the triangle slits that you saw. These go near the chin area. So I'm going to go ahead and sew those together on both sides. Sorry that my arm is on the way, but it's kind of hard to film sewing videos. So I finished that side, I backstitch it, and then I'm gonna go ahead and do the other side. Okay, so now the next step, what I'm going to do is I'm going to stitch all the way around, but not the bottom portion of the pattern. So I'm just going around with a 1/4-inch stitch to close it up in here. So I'm done in here, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and turn it around. So I turn it around, and then I went ahead and stitch the other area. That will be the chin, the nose area, and then I'm gonna close it up on the inside. So as you can see, I stitched it on the outer areas. Now in this one, I am going to add the nose wire. In the beginning of the video, you saw me wearing it without the wire. And that is because I was trying to see if it would work well with the glasses, because I found it that with the wire, it kind of slides down, the glasses slide down. Even if I put the wire on the inside, I have tried other masks that I put the wire on the inside so it doesn't show. So I decided that I was going to try to put the wire on the outside. Maybe it will give me some leverage. I found that the mask, did fit better. It was a little snug with the actual wire. It fit well, so I guess if you're concerned about inhaling germs, it has a better seal. But at the same time, if you wear glasses, they kind of slide around with the nose piece. And I found that out in several kinds of masks that I've done, so this is not the exception. I'm trying to figure out if I can do the nose wire maybe at a lower level, trying to create kind of like a stop for the glasses, but I still haven't found that solution yet. So meanwhile, when I go out and wear my mask, I just do it without, I mean, I do it without my glasses. I only need glasses for reading, so for now that's working. And what I'm doing here is basically I am stitching the nose piece with just regular stitching with my regular needle and my thread. It doesn't look that finished, but I figure, it's better than having to mess around with the sewing machine and trying to figure out how to sew it on the inside, like a lot of tutorials that I've seen. But, this one works for me, and I'm gonna continue doing it, and you'll see the finish. Peace. Okay, so I'm gonna finish the right side here and just notch it out and finish it. Put a knot in here. And the mask is done and it fits really well. It looks good. And as you can see, it with the clip, it fits better. There's no gaps. Well, thanks for watching and stay safe and keep praying. So may God take this pandemic away from us. And until next time, happy crafting!